Just checking my sound levels. I don't know. I'm using the tablet again. Hey, it's Drew. Camera. There. Hi, hey, from Sweden. It's me again. Yeah, so, I am not gonna be able to do any live streaming from here. The equipment's just not good enough for it. Fine, but you will get some more updates. Because things just keep happening, and, latest is that, well, I brought some green stuff with me to do my work. Started running out real fast. I was like, oh, I need more than I thought. Yeah, great, except I'm in Europe now. You know what that means. Yeah, so my little solution back at home in the United States, order fresh stuff from Pennsylvania, where it comes, you know, where it's made, where green stuff is made. That's not a solution here. I'm stuck with you guys. You guys being those of you in Europe who have been, like, suffering, buying from, you know, companies like Greenstuff World that have been selling. I've been told Greenstuff World has been selling you guys really stale crap. We've talked about this. Anybody who's new to my channel doesn't know what I'm talking about, there are other videos in the archives you can go back and take a look at where I'm really, really going crazy on, like, this trend for green stuff to kind of phase out of the industry. It's fine if, like, sculptors are choosing better products, better alternatives, but that's not exactly what's happening. You know, everybody's a different case, but it seems the trend is that green stuff is going out of fashion, mostly because nobody knows what it's supposed to be like. That is to say, a lot of people are buying their green stuff really stale and old and, frankly, worthless. And a lot of those people either, they just give up, which is understandable, or worse yet, they don't even know that green stuff can be really, really good because they've never had it good. They just get this stale crap and they're like, is this what it's supposed to be? How am I supposed to use this? Screw this! And they go and they buy something different. You know, like a bee's putty or whatnot. Yeah, so, it's an unboxing video. So, is this thing gonna be in reverse when I upload it? Fine, whatever. You know what it says. It says green stuff from Greenstuff World. Here it is. I am going to find out for a fact, live on this camera, whether or not... Oh my god, this plastic is just coming apart. Okay, fine, whatever. So... Now is, like, I guess the last chapter, or maybe second to last chapter, of my little adventures in trying to figure out what to expect from green stuff, and where to get it, and how to get it. If you don't know already, and I'm selling green stuff now. I went ahead, took the fresh stock that I'm getting from PSI, and I put it up for sale. It's in my store. I keep it up near the top of the store so you know where to find it, because there's no category for it. It's the only thing I've got there, the sculpting-wise. Everything else is, you know, miniatures. There's miniatures, 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 and oh, look, green stuff. I might add some more sculpting supplies, materials in there in the future, but for now, it's just the green stuff. Fresh green stuff. Refrigerated. No, no. Frozen green stuff. So that when you buy it from me, you know that it's fresh. It came straight from PSI, well, within about a few weeks. It sure as hell has been sitting around in the warehouse for months on end, like some sellers have been doing lately. That's the thing. It's a cycle. The sellers don't rotate the green stuff stock they have fast enough because people aren't buying it like they used to, because when people do buy it, they find it stale and kind of worthless for doing a lot of miniatures detailing. So it stays, the rotation just stagnates. So more green stuff isn't ordered because it's still in the stock, and it just gets worse and worse. Anyway, so here I go. Gonna open this up and check it out. Now, normally, if we were doing this back in my studio in Michigan, I would have a camera pointed down on it, and we get to, like, look at it together. I'm just gonna have to pull this up and show it to you as I'm working with it. Okay, step one, this backing. So this is the blister. I'm discovering this. Those of you who have bought Greenstuff World Greenstuff before, you know the deal. This is my first time with it. So this is the blister, clamshell. This is the clamshell that it came in. Has a fresh smell about it, somewhat. So this plastic backing is here, and the blue part is kind of stuck to it. If I saw this in the case, a jewel case from PSI, the original manufacturers of Greenstuff, I'd be slightly concerned, but let's keep going. All right, now I'm gonna cut. Do I have scissors with me? Yeah, they're there. My best scissors, they confiscated at the airport over in Heathrow. I was like, what do you mean it's too long? It's under 4 inches. TSA standard. Oh, it's gotta be under 2. I was like, what? But I've got scissors here, I'm good. All right, so this is that separated thing that I keep hearing about, and now I've got it. And this is the thing, I mean, I'm prepared to find out that this stuff's in pretty good condition, but what I'm here to argue is that this is a little bit of a gimmick. Yeah, it's nice that the blue and the yellow are separated, because if those of you know, if the blue and the yellow are in contact with each other in storage, they're going to catalyze. There's going to be a little bit of pre-catalyzation in the joint between the two. And you don't want that because you can't use that. It won't mix properly. You have to throw it all away. It's scrap. To the best of my understanding, what I'm looking at here... You know, I don't know what I'm looking at here exactly. So, to the best of my knowledge, Greenstuff World acquires this from Silmasta in the UK. Silmasta acquires theirs from PSI in the United States. I don't know. I was going to look at this and see, how did they separate this? Did they like deliberately take the ribbon, pull it apart, and then cut out the joint in the middle? Because when it's manufactured over in the United States, it doesn't have the gap. So where'd the gap come from? And I thought if I bought this and I got it, I'd be able to look at it and examine it. It's like, oh, that's how they did it. This ribbon looks kind of the same as... I mean, the same width? Let me see here. This is a little remnant of original PSI neodotype. It's a little squished, of course. And I'm holding up against this one. Just trying to, yeah, there's less blue. I don't understand. So, live on this camera, you got me not understanding what I'm looking at. Okay, fine. This feels nice, this ribbon. So far, it has a nice silky softness to it. Like, if you go back and you watch how my unboxing and testing of the PSI one, you'll see the scene where I say, oh, and see how it unrolls, how it flops out. If it like sticks and holds its shape too much, you know it's been in storage for a while. This isn't really holding its shape. This whole 36 inch roll, it's spooling out pretty freshly. It's coming out pretty nice. I like what I'm getting here. I'm excited. Because frankly, I don't have time to mess around with stale stuff. I've got to get some good sculpting done with some nice fresh stuff, and I'm really hoping for the best here. Alright, let's go ahead and undo this a little bit and take a pinch, and I'm going to test. First, I'm going to take a look at the surface. If there's going to be skinning, I find that the yellow starts to present before the blue. Blue seems cool. Oh, wait a minute. Hang on. Let me take my time here. Uh, yellow. It's soft. I'll give it that. It is soft. Has a slight. Yeah, there's a little bit of like a. Yeah. I think there's this a slight skinning going on, but at the stage that it's at right now, I don't know if I'd see any remnants in a blend. So let's go ahead, take a little bit here and mix it together and see if we get any little yellow chunks in my mix. I really don't know. I'm 50-50. It's performing pretty nicely. Let's see here. Again, I wish that I had more cameras than just this one, but we'll make do. Okay. Ah, come on. All right, so it's a little bit slower to mix than the freshest green stuff. Not terrible. Okay. That's a pretty consistent color. Yeah. Again, the smell is pretty nice. That is to say, when you get your fresh green stuff really fresh, you open it up, it has a particularly strong fresh smell to the plastics. That is not for me sticking the green stuff up my nose. No, I'm in luck. I am in luck. So far, I don't see any chunks in here. I wish I could really show this to you in our video. But this blend, excuse me, camera here. This blend isn't too bad. I don't know if I can get the camera to focus on that, but I'm gonna go ahead and use this plastic that it came in. Now, one of the things I'm gonna be doing with this green stuff is refrigerating it. Pretty soon. Right away. I'll just cut off this piece here. It's cut off. I'll use that. I'll put the rest of this away in the freezer and ask my uncle to remind me not to leave it behind. Because I probably won't be coming back here for another year, and I... Actually, that's not a bad idea. Maybe I should just leave it in the freezer. I'll be back next year to use it again. It'll be frozen, so it'll probably be fine. I'm testing the tackiness with my dental tool. A little bit of feathering. Certainly has the stickiness that I need from it. I'm liking what I'm seeing. Okay, so this green stuff that, oh gosh, where did I get it from? I'm in Sweden. I've never bought green stuff before in Sweden. I've never bought green stuff from anywhere over here before. So, where am I? I forget. I remember it. Just a second. I forget what the Swedish word is. Alpha Spel. So it's Alpha Games. Yeah, in Stockholm. Thank you guys for sending me some decent batch of green stuff. You did good by me, and I appreciate it very much. You sent it to me. You got it to me within just a day and a half of ordering it. That's also credit to the postage service here. I know, you sent it to me, DHL. Hey, special. Okay, so, yeah, I think I'm good. I have enough green stuff now to continue working on Sons of Crom 2. Nice. And most importantly, for this little unboxing video, I have now experienced in person receiving Greenstuff World Greenstuff product that's workable. I can use this. Now, that's a decision to disregard all the other people who've been messaging me and in my chat and everything, saying, oh, I got some stale stuff from Greenstuff World and I never bought from them again. Yeah, so it's a luck of the draw. I mean, we know from experience now, based on what I was doing, that PSI created a whole new batch of Greenstuff this spring and distributed it. What was that, late April? Into May? It has been a few months now. This feels pretty good for, like, something that's, like, a good... What? April, May, May to June. It's over 3 months old. Not bad. But again, I still say, if you can get Greenstuff directly from PSI in their original packaging, you might be better off. I still have a policy against buying Greenstuff that's been repackaged. That said, this is pretty alright. So, I'm gonna go ahead and sign off now. So, this is me and what I'm gonna be doing for the next week or two. Just uploading videos for S&Gs. The next one, I wish I could do a live stream with you, because there's some good sculpting I want you to follow along with, but yeah, when these things are looking really good, I'll probably do another video. Or if something else, Seder Art Studio topic-wise comes up, that too. I have a bat rep to develop, because I last upload I said that I didn't get any gaming on at Boyle. That is true, but I did get a game on at Warhammer World. And I didn't just do any game at Warhammer World. I got to play a game with Tim Pollard, the guy who's doing writing for Seder Art Studio and the guy who did a lot of writing for GW. He worked GW back in the golden days, from its dawning hours, and he worked as art director, assistant art director with John Blanche and everything. He was there in the middle of it. All those crazy names for all the figures in the release, the catalog releases, those were just done up by him on the fly. And yeah, so he happens to have on hand a whole bunch of art and miniatures from the golden era of Games Workshop. Some people know this, it's legendary. His house is just dripping with the stuff. And I walked into his studio and I saw some of the figures on the shelf and I was like, he's got a lot of dust on them, Tim. When was the last time you played with them? To which he said, well, I haven't played anything with them. And I was like, so these have never been used in a game before? They're featured in the Rogue Trader book, but they've never been played with? And he just kind of shrugged his shoulders and I was like, we're going to fix this. So I came back the next day with a can of compressed air, sprayed the dust off of them, said, let's go. And we took the figures down to head-to-head against my figures on the table there at Warhammer World. And that's special because I got to enjoy playing a game, an old-fashioned Rogue Trader 40K game, against the figures from the book when I first saw it, you know, back in the late 80s. And it's like, oh, I gotta have that. Well, there they are on the table. It was a bit of a hash because we just made the game up on the fly, very apropos and very old hammer, and we had a great time. And his daughter did too. She was there, and she really mixed it up. Anyway, putting the bat rep for that together. Actually, we might get two different bat reps. He might be uploading one himself. He loves to write. I might see it from him soon. Might see it from before me, because I got a lot going on before I go back home. That's it for now, so that might come up later. Yeah. Okay, I'm signing off. Talk to you guys later. See ya. Bye.